What's up guys, AntsCzech here, with the long-awaited update on my polycystic paper wasp colony. It took me more than a year to find some time and to make it, and I'm sorry about that. But without further ado, today we'll see how the wasp colony is doing. We'll find out what name had been chosen for them, and look at the construction of the paper wasp nest. Also, a reminder, this video is a re-edit and covers the development since May to July 2020. Since mid-May, my observation notes haven't been so frequent. After a while, it has become a bit repetitive. Throw in crickets in the morning, refill water and sugar once in a while, change cardboard, check conditions, occasionally post a photo on Instagram about their development and also try counting them. But it's true that when you stop for a while and watch what they're doing, it's interesting. On the 17th of May, I counted over 26 individuals. The colony had a lot of larvae and pupae. On the 23rd of May, I found something I didn't expect at all. One of the larvae was lying under the nest. It was still alive and you could see it on Instagram. What could have caused it? It is possible that the larva just fell out of the chamber. Sometimes that definitely can happen. Or, given the appetite of this colony, it is possible that the weaker wasp larvae have been discarded so that the stronger ones that have already developed can continue to grow? My presumptions turned out to be wrong. An experienced wasp keeper told me that they throw out work larvae to make space for male and female brood, or simply throw out larvae if they are sick. A few days later, I found the first three males dead, and also one worker, probably due to the short lifespan of the males and already old workers. Also, on the 3rd of June, another larva was laying a little further than directly under the nest. They didn't even touch it and let it burn in the sun. I've only found a fallen larva a few times since then. What do you think about it? Do they make space for reproductives? Or is there perhaps another reason? During June, they began to expand the nest once again, and the first slightly larger cocoons emerge next to the others. Behind them will be the pupae of young queens, who should begin to eclose abundantly in July. On the 13th of June, the colony had about 43 individuals, of which 5 were dead. A month later, on the 13th of July, the nest is even larger, more cocoons of new reproductives, and a lot of males are waiting around the nest. After occasional feeding with mealworms and older crickets, the walls and the bottom are considerably dirty. Wasps do not consume the intestines of worms and throw parts of them along the walls. Older crickets are not as tasty and good as young ones, so there are often more leftovers. and there is a problem with the growing number of reproductive individuals, young males and queens. The question arises how to take care of them. Those of you who have seen the previous video about wasps know that fertile individuals fly to certain places where they mate, and females there often stay and overwinter. Therefore, it would be ideal to make a smaller hole in the side of the insectarium so that the reproductives can fly out and be useful in the nature. We will probably deal with that in another video about wasps. Now let's take a look at the construction of the nest. The nest is placed on the initial stem. The material is chewed sources of cellulose, trees, fences, houses, exposed pieces of wood, cardboard and more, mixed with saliva to form paper pulp after drying. At first, the first few cell beginnings are located on the stem, each with one egg inside it. Gradually, the queen adds more cell beginnings and enlarges the ones in the middle as needed. The shape of the nest is often a circle or rounded rectangle, where the center always has the longest cells and the smallest are on the edges. Nests are attached on one stem, or the large ones, or several stems. The original Czech species of paper wasps have a maximum of several dozen cells, but the European paper wasp can have more than 100. Now let's talk about the method of placing brood and sugars. I created a few simple pictures based on my observations. The first cells are dedicated only to eggs from which the workers develop. The first cells with the honey stalks start to appear on the edges. The nest grows, eggs, larvae, pupae and sugar stores increase. When the new individuals close, they are replaced by sugar stalks. The stalks that are stored at the edges are moved to the center, to the empty positions from the pupae. But again, after a while, there are new eggs instead of sugars. Thus, the process repeats with the growth of the nest. The most used cells are the darkest, i.e. the cells closest to the center. In the end, however, the center is used only for the sugar stalks. This is based purely on my observations and can be wrong or inaccurate. And the last thing to talk about is the nest my grandmother threw down in her greenhouse. You can see the elongated shape, small outer and large inner cells, as well as darker cells in the middle. The nest has already been cleared out by ants, therefore there are no larvae inside. But we can take a closer look at the pupae. The larvae are white, but gradually turn yellow before pupating. The young pupa is yellow. It takes about 2 weeks for the imago to eclode from it. A few days before eclosing, the pupa is dark like this. Gradually, after closing, the young adult wasp gets out of the cell, enclosed by the fiber lid, which it made as a larva. The adult gradually bites the lid, and from the outside it looks like holes have appeared in it. But what do we do with the rest of the nest? Should I try to add it to my wasp colony by sticking it next to them with glue? Or should I feed the rest of the pupae to my ant colonies? What do you think I did? Try to guess what happened in the comments before the last paper wasp update comes out. Well, that's the end of this video. At last, enjoy a time lapse of wasps and their collection of nest building materials. I hope you enjoyed the third video about paper wasp keeping. Please share it on other social media and don't be afraid to ask anything in the comments. Like and subscribe, thanks a lot, and bye!